Okay, now I decided to go with a hazy grey skies. Certainly on the warm side of things. Very handy for shaping your trees when you paint your sky. Feed into them here and there. I can always push that back in if I need to. Getting a little bit grey there. I might just put a bit more red with that, I think. And take me a moment. Yeah, that's a bit better. Sky gets over to the right hand side more. I think I might add a touch of yellow into it because it'll be nearer the sun. Just a tiny touch of yellow into that greyish violet. I think that's a bit nicer. Get around the tree. Nice gentle touch with a good soft brush. Okay, now for the foliage, I get a nice wide flat. Mix up some dark to start with. This is Spectrum Blue mixed with phthalo green, bit of white, touch of red, and we'll start working on some foliage as it comes out into and across the sky. Another lovely soft brush. Clean it off on the backboard if you pick up too much sky colour. too sure how far across I want to bring these. Something a little bit greener, just a bit more phthalo green, and a little bit more white, just to break that colour up a bit, put a hint of light in it, therefore a hint of colour. Yeah, it's quite a bluey green, that one. Take that a bit further, I think. A bit more white into that blue green. It's something you just get a feel for as you're going. I don't go in with too many preconceptions. I just like to solve problems as they arrive, if I can. No, not quite white enough yet. Brush. I can add some twigs, branches, and even some individual leaves. Be a good idea if they reach that tree and get past the peak of the shed. Rather than just stopping short of it. Dead one in there somewhere, just there maybe, or a bare one at least. It's good at this stage of the painting, I've got brushes for every colour I want pretty much. didn't quite get the shape I want there against the wall, but that's okay, I can paint that back with some wall colour. Carefully. Better. I'm not sure we'd see a shadow on the ground for something which is up over the crest. I think I might go without that. But I will emphasize some of the darks. Head there, I think. Is that better? Oops. Oh, I've got a shadow under it. I didn't really mean to do that. But that's alright. These trees over here, we can certainly eat into them. A bit, gives them some sky holes. Be very gentle, I'll quite often mop them back with my finger or thumb. Bring a bit of sky down over that and then push it back up. Anything which varies the handling is a good thing. Some distant trees there. I'd go for another one just in front here, I think. I don't know if I can get away with one in there. One just in here, we'll find out. Don't be afraid to give it a go. If it doesn't work out, you can always paint it away. That seems okay. Try and get a bit of light on it. Enjoy doing trees and sky at the same time. I really think they very much depend on each other. Just felt it needed a bit of light variation there. some edges away. Maybe a bit more green and yellowy green down low, I think. They're a little bit closer to us. Loose brush strokes, light touch. A few light accents in there might be nice. I don't know what they are. But it just adds a little bit of interest in the few more highlights on the grasses there. Some branches and these distant trees, maybe. Yep, I think they work all right. Play up the highlight against that shadow on the track. And maybe a few leaves out here. just sort of nip those into the surface rather than leave them